Hi, I'm Carter Emhart. I'm here to take you through some tutorials for OpenSpace. The first thing is to launch OpenSpace. I have come to the directory where we have put OpenSpace on our machine here at the American Museum of Natural History, but when you open up that directory, you should see the list of subdirectories, and if you go in the bin directory, we'll be able to come down to the OpenSpace Exe, the OpenSpace executable. Click twice on that, and it should launch. Should see a splash screen here in a second. We'll show all the loading of the various elements that are coming up. And so what I want to just do in this quick intro is to show you how to navigate, how to get the menus open, and perhaps how to resize the screen. Currently, the field of view is set to about 40 degrees, I believe. In the future, we'll be able to scale that, but not for now. So what I'm going to do is just come down here and grab here, and I can expand the window out. Great. Now, this is what we see. We are defaulted on Earth, and we're using the mouse to navigate. So here we have the left, middle, and right. In this case, a middle roller. Mouse key essentially stand in, but by using a three-button mouse like this, we can fly. And what I mean by that is that we would depress, in this case, the left mouse. That means I'm grabbing a hold of the display. Now I can move around side to side, up and down by just the left mouse button. If I want to get closer or farther to the Earth, I grab the right mouse button. And if I pull the mouse toward me, I move away. We pull out or pull away. And by, again, grabbing the right mouse button or depressing it and pushing down, I can come back closer to Earth. You may also notice that there are these lines. These are trails, orbit trails, so we can see where a planet is, or something, a body like the moon, and where it's been. This enables us to kind of see where the planets are and also the paths they trace out. So if I come down like this and look back toward the sun, I can see the trails of the inner and the outer planets. So there's Mercury and Venus, and also by looking outbound, I'm just gonna see, well, I see the moon, and then I see Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, and the outer planets. So let's come in close to the Earth once again. And now to bring up the menus, we have the F2 key. That brings up our simple menus. For in this case, I have time and space control up here. And then down here is our object list that we'll use to explore. In advanced cases, we can bring up with the F key, the advanced menu as well. But what I'm gonna do is I'm just F2 as a toggle, and I bring up F2, I'll just see the ones that I want right here. For time control, we see that there is a feature down here called Delta Time. And what this allows, and also I have the tooltips turned on, so right now they're sort of like training wheels for you in learning how to use OpenSpace, but we can also turn the tooltips off. I find that after a while they get in the way. But in this case, with Delta Time, once again, I'm grabbing it, and if I just start moving it to the right, we see the Earth proceeding in positive time. And if I drag it to the left, we can go back in time. So in this way, we can kind of turn the Earth to a pose that we might like. And we can either pause it, or if I want to go back to now, there's the now button up here, and I can just jump to that. So that's the current pose of Earth. And so then I can maneuver around as I like. Also, the middle mouse button, I didn't mention it other than pointing it out, but in depressing the middle mouse, it allows us to roll. So once again, left mouse allows me to move around or orbit in whatever direction I want. And the right mouse is proximity, near and far. And then The middle mouse, or depressing, in this case, the roller wheel, just holding it, allows me to sort of straighten up the image if we want to do that. So with that, it's a simple introduction. Thank you.